So now we'll discuss one more thing. That is, Bhagavatam sometimes gives dimensions for earthly objects that seem to be unbelievable. So, for example, the Himalayas are said to be thousands of miles high. So, how exactly is it possible? We know that the Himalayas are not, we have climbed on top of the Himalayas, many people have. So, here the concept of Adhikar comes up. So, the idea is that the universe is like a complex computer. A simple example to understand this. So, if there's a very, very sophisticated high-end computer, then a data entry operator might be working on that computer and they may have access to only a small portion of the computer. You enter data over here, you enter data over here, that's all. And apart from that, they may not be able to access anything else. And for them, the computer is only maybe this 50 GB. But actually, the computer might have 50 terabyte of data. But somebody who has the appropriate level of access, maybe the CEO or the top officers, they can get all the 50 TB data. So although they are accessing, both are accessing the same computer, they are not accessing at the same level. So similarly, just like a computer can have multiple levels of access, so similarly, the universe, there are certain objects in the universe which can be accessed at different levels by different people. Just like even if physically we go to Chandraloka, we access it only in three dimensions. We don't access the higher levels of Chandraloka. So similarly, just like the Ganga, we perceive the Ganga as it flows through Gangotri here. But the Ganga as it exists in the higher levels, if the higher planets themselves are subtle, then the water also there is going to be subtle. So the Ganga which is in the higher levels, we will not be able to perceive it from here. So similarly, the Himalayas, they exist on the earth and they exist at higher levels of reality also. So the same hard disk, it is seen as having different amounts of data by different people. Similarly, the Himalayas, depending on the Adhikar, it is seen differently by different people. So this is also called as state-specific knowledge. That means the knowledge that we pursue depends on the state of our consciousness. To some extent, quantum physics talks a lot about this, that the state, that it is the observer who determines what can be seen. And if the observer is not there, then the perception will be different. Now, Einstein himself found quantum physics very difficult to accept. One of his famous quotes condemning quantum physics is that he said, "I would like to believe that the moon continues to exist even if I am not looking at it." And he said, obviously moon continues to exist, but according to quantum physics, it doesn't. Quantum physics, there are simply waves, and when there's an observer, then the waves coagulate and we see gross objects at that time. So we are not going to quantum physics, but the idea of state-specific knowledge, that the observer determines the observation, that is something which is not alien to science. So similarly, depending on the state of consciousness of the observer, certain areas of the universe are perceived and certain aren't perceived. So when we talk about perceiving higher realities, how are they to be perceived? There are broadly three things over there. There is some amount of visual perception, but there is also to be intellectual comprehension. And then after that, there is spiritual realization. So when all these three come together, that's when we perceive. And this applies for Himalayas. This also applies, say, for Vrindavan. Now, we may go to Vrindavan, but we don't see Vrindavan just by seeing with our eyes. Now, still, seeing with our eyes is important. Still, we are recommended that we go to Vrindavan. But don't go there with a sightseeing mood. We go there with, yes, we see with our eyes, but our eyes are guided by the description of scriptures. And not only are they guided by description of scriptures, but our heart is filled with the devotion that comes by associating with great devotees. And then we pursue those higher realities. So the same is depicted in a different way. If you consider a triangle, these three things, sensory perception, scriptural description, and then prayerful contemplation or spiritual realization. So as these three increase, then we see the dham more and more. So we see with our eyes, but don't just see with our eyes. We remember with our head and then we pray with our heart. Then the divine Vrindavan will be revealed to us. So all three need to be combined together.